This innovative treatment can delay dialysis up to 4 years in stage 4 and 5 CKD patients. And it's already been approved! Katherine from Double O Kidney here, welcome to our journey together to a better kidney health. Ast 120, commercialized as Kremezin, is basically a magic pill that delays dialysis in kidney disease patients. And I'm not even kidding! This is a treatment based on activated charcoal, which is approved to significantly delay dialysis in people with kidney problems. But Ast 120 is not just your standard activated charcoal. It is different on a molecular level, and it has been approved to delay dialysis in patients in stage 4 and even 5 of CKD. And it can really do this. I mean, doctors in Japan, Korea, Taiwan, and the Philippines wouldn't be prescribing this treatment otherwise. Now, the very first question here is, does it really work? A large review of studies published on the journal Nephron concluded that Ast 120 has beneficial effects in preventing the kidney damage as well as systematic complications associated with uremia. In particular, there is a double-blind placebo-controlled study showing significant improvement in serum creatinine slope after 24 weeks of treatment, an improvement of uremic symptoms, nausea, anorexia, pruritus, and halitosis from 2 weeks after the initiation of treatment. So, the subjects of this study, who were all in stage 4 and 5 pre-dialysis, not just had a significant improvement in kidney function in the short term, they also had immediate results in terms of symptoms. They had less nausea, itching, and bad breath in just 2 weeks. If this is not enough, a different study focused on the possibility for patients to delay dialysis with this treatment concluded that Ast 120 delays the decline in renal function. In addition, Ast 120 may delay the initiation of dialysis in progressive CKD via renal protection. So, this cheap remedy is so good at protecting the kidneys from damage that it slows down kidney disease and delays the start of dialysis in patients with stage 4 and 5 kidney disease. Researchers think that it can delay dialysis to up to 4 years. So, if you think this is good news, please share this video with anyone you know who suffers from kidney problems. We really need to focus on the awareness about this new kind of treatment. If more people knew about the studies I'm showing you today, things could be very different for patients on dialysis. This kind of research could literally save millions of people. So share this video now. And I know what you want to ask right now. How do I get this treatment? In today's video, I'll share with you all the info you need to get prescribed this miraculous treatment. First of all, it depends on where you live. As I was saying, Ast 120 was approved in Japan in 1991, followed by Korea in 2004, in Taiwan in 2007, and in the Philippines in 2010. And I know that many of you guys follow me from the Philippines. Yay! So let me know if you have ever heard about this treatment or if your doctor has actually prescribed it to you. Let's talk about it in comment section. It's going to be very interesting for everyone if any of you guys watching me right now is already using Ast 120. If this is the case, please share your opinion. But don't worry if your doctor never told you about this treatment, because while it was approved in Japan already in 1991, The Philippines only approved it in 2010, and in the world of medical treatments, 11 years are like 2 days. So many doctors probably are not familiar with AST 120 yet. But if you want to try it, my suggestion here will be to print some of the studies about this treatment, which I have linked down in the description, and bring them with you to your next doctor appointment. Talk to your doctor about it. And what if you live in the US, in India, or in Europe? There is a big controversy going on in the scientific community about why and if this treatment should be used in these countries too. As we have seen, there is plenty of evidence showing that it can help. But also, AST120 was never used in these countries outside of some small trials. One of the reasons why it's not used is probably the cost. AST120 is incredibly cheap, especially when compared to the cost of dialysis and other medical treatments for chronic kidney disease. And cost saving is in the interest of governments of countries such as Korea and Japan, where healthcare is publicly financed and universally accessible. Large studies were made just to assess how much money AST120 can save by delaying dialysis. In this study, researchers concluded that AST120 can save the equivalent of $26,000 per patient per year. This is a Korean study, clearly. AST120 was studied in the US too, and even if the results were promising, this treatment was never approved by the FDA for CKD. So, if you live in the US, you cannot have this treatment right now. So the question here is this all about the money? Well, there could be another reason. As I was saying, we are talking about the carbon absorbent here. The way AST120 works is very simple. Patients take it after meals and it binds to uremic toxins in the intestine. Then it helps excrete uremic toxins with the feces. Uremic toxins, the main cause of kidney disease symptoms such as nausea, pruritus, and fatigue, are usually removed in the urines. When the kidneys are not able to remove them, this treatment can help by having the gut getting rid of these toxins instead. Clearly, this can remove a great burden from the kidneys and help them improve. In fact, this treatment is also being used to treat uremic symptoms such as nausea, fatigue, troubles breathing, and itching, even in dialysis patients. The problem is that the approved dosage and administration of AST120 is 6 grams per day. It's a pretty high dosage, which makes it difficult for patients to take AST120 for extended periods. Another problem is that very few people know about this treatment and not many efforts are being done to promote it. I always say that spreading the awareness is the most important thing when it comes to pushing research. So share this video right now with anyone you know who is suffering from kidney disease. Let them know about this. Now guys, if you have already watched my video about activated charcoal, you may have noticed that AST120 is very similar to activated charcoal. The next question is, can oral activated charcoal give the same results as AST120? Well, while they are both activated charcoal, they're not exactly the same thing. In the clinical trial I've shown you in my video about activated charcoal, it's up here if you haven't watched it. Activated charcoal was used in a clinical trial conducted on 9 very old stage 5 patients who wanted to avoid dialysis. And while they were able to get the wanted results to avoid dialysis in kidney disease stage 5, regular activated charcoal has shown significant disadvantages compared to AST120. First of all, patients need to take 30 grams of activated charcoal per day. 30 grams is 1/3 of this bottle I have here. You can imagine that it's not easy to swallow all this black powder that really tastes like charcoal every day. But also, this substance binds to everything, not just uremic toxins, so patients taking it are at greater risk for malnutrition and vitamin insufficiencies. AST-120 is different on a molecular level. It binds more to uremic toxins than regular activated charcoal. While it can still bind to things you need, so patients are advised not to take it with medications, it is so effective at removing uremic toxins, patients need to take just 6 grams a day of it. Now guys, for those of you living outside the Philippines or Japan, I have a word of caution here. If you Google this product, AST-120 or Kremezin, you will find some websites selling this product to you directly from Japan for a small price. Several websites offer this both on the clear web and on the dark web. Well, don't trust them. These are the same websites that sell antibiotics and other prescription drugs without the need for a prescription. It may sound good to find something that it's not available in your country, but what if the website gets shut down and you can't get it anymore? And also, will you trust a shady website enough to gulp down whatever they will send you without being able to know if it's really what you need? I don't think so. On the bright side, trials on this treatment are still being made, so we can hope it will be available in the Western world soon. And let me know in comment section if you are interested in knowing more about this treatment. And also subscribe and set the notification bell to all if you want me to keep you updated about this and any other development in the treatment of kidney disease. And by the way, a very interesting new video is coming next Tuesday, and I really hope to see you there. In the meantime, keep taking good care of your kidneys and be good to yourself. This is all for today. Thank you for watching.